The forests of Sri Lanka rise above the rest of the country, like islands out of the sea. Here, species found nowhere else in the world have been marooned on high forest plateaus. A purple-faced leaf monkey, found nowhere else except Sri Lanka. And this variety lives only in the country's lush rainforests. It rarely descends to the ground, instead choosing to mate and feed with its troop in the relative safety of the treetops. Branches and vines make for great playgrounds. Some youngsters can get a little carried away. But it's clear, when they're frolicking in the foliage, that these leaf monkeys belong to the trees. Sri Lanka's rainforests are found only in one small part of the island. Two-thirds of Sri Lanka is dominated by lowland plains, where harsh, dry seasons dictate the rhythm of life. But in the mountainous southwest corner of the island, rains keep the lands lush throughout the year. Here, in dense rainforests, the competition for finite resources has propelled evolution. With three-quarters of Sri Lanka's biodiversity found in the wet zone, species adapting to exploit every centimeter of the forest. The result is a profusion of life, where colorful gems glint in the green. Home to trapeze artists and extravagant dressers. A place where robins look like magpies. And magpies look like clowns. The rare Sri Lankan blue magpie. To survive in these forests, it helps not to be picky. Fruits, frogs, and insects are all on the menu. Caterpillars are a favorite treat. The problem is, they have spiny hairs to deter most birds. He, however, has a clever trick. He's learned a quick wipe on a branch will remove any of the itchy fur. But he's not preparing supper for himself. He has two other mouths to feed. These birds are found nowhere else on Earth but Sri Lanka's rainforest. And their unusual parenting technique is almost as unique. Both parents raise the brood, but only mum incubates the new arrivals. Frantically waggling her wings is a code for dad to hand over his latest catch. Nothing too unusual about that. But this pair enlists other helpers too. For their older offspring, having chicks of their own would be unsustainable when competition for resources is tough. So younger members of the flock have to wait their turn to breed. Everyone pitches in to make sure this year's small brood survives. Brother, sister, aunts and uncles all help to forage for food. Raising a brood in this way is sensible when territories are scarce. So in these crowded forests, this family seems to have found a clever way to ensure the survival of each new generation. Protecting young and ensuring the survival of your species is not easy, especially in a place where competition for territory is unrelenting. Across Sri Lanka's forests, another ancient civilization has carved out his own niche. Man. Survival techniques have been passed down from generation to generation. Each dawn and dusk, he cuts a thin layer from the flowers of this kittle palm to release sap. It's used to make sweet jaggery, Sri Lanka's answer to sugarcane. The trees provide an income for his family, as they have done for centuries. Some take sustenance from the trees. Others have found the forests provide more. This is the most sacred of all Sri Lanka's forests. On the tallest forest peak in the north of the island, an ancient and reclusive order of forest monks devote themselves to a life of perfect solitude. Many of the plants here were once used by them as medicines, the monks taking only what they needed from the trees. Today, the forest cradles the remains of their Ayurvedic hospital, where they ground plants and herbs, which they believed contained the power to heal. One quarter of the plants in Sri Lanka are found nowhere else. And of these, 60% are found only in its rainforests. Hot sun causes moisture to rise from the land almost as fast as the rain can fall. Each day it condenses into great clouds which dance across the canopy, preparing to fall as rain once more. But climb higher into its mountainous heart, and a startlingly different forest is revealed. Hidden away in the highlands are Sri Lanka's cloud forests. Here, temperatures are lower. December and January bring frost to the high hills, and temperatures can fall below zero. The upward movement of cool air condenses into a thick mist. Trees, bent double like old men, stunted and gnarled, are cloaked with almost constant moisture. As night falls across Sri Lanka's remaining forests, a net of stars is cast across the trees. Caught in the glow of their soft light, spiders, porcupines, and bats emerge from the gloom. A new set of creatures competing for the same resources as their daytime neighbors. A ghostly apparition. Once Sri Lanka would have been filled with these strange creatures. One of the most ancient primates in the world. The slender loris. As his forest habitat has shrunk, so too has his presence. This male lives deep in the monsoon forests in the lowlands of the country. But his mountain-dwelling cousins have been brought to the brink of extinction. Tonight, he has his own survival in mind, seeking out the ripest of the fruits of the forest. Using his lanky limbs, with specially adapted hands and feet, he maneuvers across spindly branches. A dexterous and nimble predator, whose tastes run to more than just fruit. Got it. A juicy dragonfly. With supper over, it's time to attend to more pressing matters. He spies a female loris amongst the branches. The pair renew their bonds, licking and swapping scent. While males are known to share territories, females are more possessive. Her brief encounter over, she deposits urine on a branch and leaves a clear message. This is her territory. As the full moon continues to light up the night sky, its beams coax the catapult flower to reveal its fragile beauty. One of the few plants on Earth to bloom at night. Sri Lanka's reverence for the natural world led to a peaceful existence between man and forest. With the forest often claiming back what was once theirs. Today, its wildlife faces the familiar pressure of competition with people over space and resources. But long before nature conservation became fashionable in the West, ancient Sri Lankans established places where nature was worshipped. And so, in these modern fractured worlds, people must be seen not as a threat, but as an opportunity for the balance to be restored. Nature doesn't need every corner of Sri Lanka to itself. But with each niche of these jungles so tightly packed with wonderful creatures, it's clear they cannot survive with any less.